right, that was Double Banjo Blues, and that was one of the many boogie tunes that Don did over the years. And he actually, this is a song that I think I had first heard him do the double roll on. And basically all it is I guess you could say it's you're doing double the amount of rolls, forward rolls, that you would normally. So... like that, instead of... so you're doubling the rolls up, but it's in the same amount of time period as your normal roll would be. So that's basically the trick to Double Banjo Blues. And there's a bunch of things you can put in this tune. It's real similar in licks and things as Reno Ride. You can put a lot of the same licks into it. But we'll start it like this. Okay. Now I have heard Don do this differently. Instead of... sliding, and you can do that, and it, like I said, don't lock yourself into what I'm doing or what Don's doing. You come up with your own ideas and your own licks, but I don't normally do that slide like that, but okay, now this is real important. I've heard a lot of people play this tune, but they always leave out that little fifth string note that Don hits in there. And that's in there, and I think it adds just a little something extra to it instead of just... you know, just continuously doing that forward roll on that those strings. Don would throw that little fifth string note in there just to give it a little pop to it, so... try that again. Like that. Hard to play it slow, but he adds that little fifth string note in there right before he goes into a C. So, and he hits this seventh note. And then he goes into C. And he actually hits the fifth again. Like that. Let me slow that down again. It's hard to play it slow, but I'll slow it down. Let me play the first part and the C part. Okay, now when I come out of that C, I'm doing it a little something different. You can come back up and hit the fifth. Normally, I do it like that. And I've heard Don do it a ton of different ways, so there's no right and wrong way to do anything in Reno style, really. There's a few guidelines, there's a lot of guidelines to follow, but it's such a free-form style, you can just really create with his style, so... And now that I'm talking about it, that makes me think of a lot of stories I've heard of Don where people would ask him to play something like he did on the record, or how they heard him play it the night before at a festival, and he would have no idea how he did it because he just played off the top of his head. So that's one of the things that you should try to get out of Reno style is be creative and don't be afraid of making mistakes. And anyway, it goes to D at this point, so. And then it goes to D. And all I'm doing is I'm running down through the D chord, and I'm actually going to double up on the second string when I go down on it. So kind of confusing. And again, notice I'm using my first finger to hit that. I didn't use my thumb at all to hit that, because Scruggs would normally hit that. Use his thumb to hit that those notes there on the third string. So Don uses his index to do that, and I'll play that whole first part slow for you one more time. Oops, sorry, I'll start again. Don's original recording of this, and he's only recorded this song once to my knowledge, but he comes up and does two different breaks, actually, other than the double rolling. And all we're going to do is come up here and we're going to hit this partial G chord on the third and first string. So I usually slide into it, but I think Don just hit it, but so all I'm doing is I'm walking from this G to this G, and I'm throwing this C, partial C chord into it. So don't be afraid, like I said, to back up on some of these double stops and, you know, use that backing up in different positions to get the melody that you want. So it's very simple, really, what he's doing here. Back to this G position, still on the third and first strings. And now he's going to do part of that Chuck Berry lick that we did. So. Okay. Now this part here is, it goes to C again. And that sounds very much like Chuck Berry type play in there, where he goes, you know. Well, we're not going to do that. You could do that, but Don didn't do that. And it's kind of a variation of it. During the C here, what he's doing is he's grabbing this partial F position, 7th, or 7th F position. And it's a G7 on the first and second string on the third fret, and he's going to grab the C on the fifth on the fifth fret on the second and third strings, and he's just going back and forth on it. And it's all a matter of the timing on it, how many times and how long to pause and how many times to hit it. So see, it gets a little fast right there. So, let me play it up to that point. Okay. There's that hammer on. strumming down through that G position, or G chord, F position. Alright, and here's the best part of this break to me, was this little bit here. And you really have to use your vamping on your right hand to get this bounce that he gets into it. So okay, so you could do it like that, or you could do it the way I did it the first time there. See, like I said, it's hard for me to stick to one way to do it. I think that's how he did it on the original, if I remember correctly. So he bounces up and down, and all he's doing is releasing the pressure. It's just like a vamp. He's not hitting the strings open like we have done in the past. He's just pressing and releasing. Okay. I'll play that whole break for you now. And then Don's, I don't remember the order from the original, but this was one of the breaks he took on it. Okay, it's very simple. All he's doing is just brushing open, and then pausing and sliding. Like I said, he can make something so simple hard by, you know, just doing a slide or pausing or sliding back and forth. It's tough. So back to this. Remember, that's where we're at. Here we're playing out of this F position, G. And there's that walk down again to go to C. Alright, and then we're going to slide up here to this C position. Again, you can do this many different ways, but this is pretty close to the original, I think, if I remember right. It's a real weird lick there. A roll, actually, and like I've said before, Don used whatever roll he wanted to get the notes that he wanted. So, again, with the double thumbing, too. He hit the bass, then hit the third string. The fourth, and then the third. So, and he comes up here, and this is kind of like Foggy Mountain Special, you know. So, it's actually a little more like Bill Monroe's Bluegrass Stomp, really, but it's out of the same positions as Foggy Mountain Special. But he's coming up here and hammering it on. The reason why I mentioned Bluegrass Special, or Bluegrass Stomp, actually, is this is how Don played Bluegrass Stomp, was something like that, but they played it in D, so I thought I'd just throw that in there in case you ever want to try to learn Bluegrass Stomp. But this little bit is kind of out of that bluegrass stomp, so and you can do, like like I said, you can just vary this up any way you want to. Do something like that. So, again, that's pretty similar to Reno Ride there at the end. Now, I didn't record this during the video clip where I was playing it, but I'll show you this because Don used this particular double roll a lot in actually Reno Ride. Later versions of Reno Ride, he did this. And it'll work for double banjo blues. And all he's doing is he's running from this F position to this D position, G chord. So this G to this G. And he's doing a double roll. It just does a one roll on the F chord. Okay. And he also did this on later versions of Little Rock Getaway, I believe, if I remember right. But, well, he doubled up on Little Rock Getaway. I'll say that anyway, but... he did do this on Reno Ride, and you can do it in banjo, double banjo blues. You can do it in any boogie tune, really. Just like Bluegrass Stomp we were talking about, Bluegrass Stomp is basically a boogie tune in D that Monroe wrote, and you could do the same break. Okay, and like I said, I'm starting at this F position, rolling forward on the 4th, 2nd and 1st strings, just one roll starting out on the F, and then slide up to this D position, G, and it's the same thing. That we did in the beginning of the song. It's the same thing, but to get this bass note, you have to start out at the lower note up here. So it's the same thing. You're still doubling up on that second string. So